skyline now. We've sketched it. We have some grass here. We've got this giant cedar off to the left, kind of framing. Very simple composition, really, which is good. And then we've got this driveway coming out forward and around. Can't really see it. Quick sketch. Just an idea of where things go. That's about it for the sketch. Gotta get to painting. So the sky, I've got some colors kind of mixed up. Oh, we have clouds now. Wow, look at that. Maybe I'll throw in a cloud or two. Cloud, I'm gonna use this gray. As Bob Ross would say, happy little clouds. He's going to start sending our eye that direction. Love the cloud. Got a nice blue sky. And in between, got the white of the cloud up in here. It's not actually white. Tinge in there. Hey, Mr. Cloud, how about it? And the blue will continue underneath there, but since it's further down in the sky, the color kind of shifts to more of a teal. Some trees in the background. I'll leave them in there. Bring this teal over here. Connect with the clouds, so I'll bring it up. A little bit of teal off in this direction. Building in. So I like to use a little scrubby brush to get a transparent dark details. Cedar. See some of the sunlight coming through him maybe. Some different layers of foliage. As you come closer, it gets darker, more saturated. So we'll have darker darks up here up front with this big patch of white sagey stuff you see on the left. So there's this purple sage right here in the middle. So this will be my white purple. This guy is just as, oh, we've got some more yuccas. Right up in the front of the picture plane. So they're going to be really big. Oh my goodness. So the trees in the background, I like to mix in a little bit of air, which will be this dark that I've been using for my transparencies. I'll add that to my green, all my darks for those distant trees. Trying to get air in my paintings. That's my challenge. I've been in the studio so long. Now that I'm out of doors, I get air. yellow really jumps forward real fast. So for a background highlight, I'll mix up my green with kind of a really dull yellow. That dulls it out a bit. So that it doesn't bring it all the way to the foreground right away. We're just going to say, there's a tree back. Still kind of blue back there, though. Don't get too crazy. Put some air in it, by the way. Put sky colors on it, too. To desaturate it. Still pretty bright green. Do I like that? Probably for the foreground instead, since it's already on my brush. I'll just change my plan and stick it where I think it belongs. That duller yellow. Maybe a little muddier for the way back. So just an idea of, it's kind of a lighter green foliage off that direction. So take it off the page. So. It's a good color. We'll use it up here. In the same kind of zone. See this back. In the very front, I'm going to pretend I can see this path that we're standing on, because I think it makes a great composition. And since I'm so recently out of the studio, I still haven't had it. So wonderful. Everybody's been very welcoming to me, even though I'm new to them. Going to turn my whites on the building into green if I get him in first, though, so I really got to paint that first, even though other colors, especially phthalo. It's a very strong, powerful green. So the sun's shining on the face of this building here. I'm trying to make my marks go in the direction of the bricks, which is that way. Left to right, mostly. I'll have to come back and redo that dark in a second. Sometimes I get over them. That's okay. Not the end of the world. Okay, now it's safe to put in that bush if I want to. And the back part of the Ney, although it is the same color brick, it's the same brick. If I want it to disappear back there, I gotta kind of tone it down a little bit, because you can only look at one thing at a time. Be a little darker, maybe. So that you can see the front. That's the main museum. More than its belt. Alright. That's a refreshment of the nose. Now for the cedar room. Dare I say it?
That's a very big cedar.
It's a very big cedar tree. Oh my goodness. It's just all over the place. You know those branches kind of bow out that way. So. Oh, we got the back side. Air color again, get a little. This is a combination of ultramarine blue and pyrrole red. Just get shadow. Once again, even though this shaded side of the Ney is not this dark, I'm putting the dark in here to highlight the front side, and also so that when I put some little details in on top of it, so for example, a couple of those bricks, just a couple of them, they show up on top. You gotta have dark to see. And now you can see. Interest over on the left, because once again I want that, so I'm just going to have that dull gray on the side. At the top of the bush, I want to have a little bit of light falling on top of it, so I use a little bit of sky, which was a cloud back there. Bring that down on top of, so the light kind of falls onto the bush. Lights it up. Dark down this cloud. Make him serious. That's a serious cloud, like we had last night on. We're going to do our greens and browns. I want to put down some dirt. I've got a nice saturated reddish. I'm going to put down the dirt so that I can then plant my plants in. Favor and put it in this time. It's a game of quick draw. Baron was at a quick draw recently, wasn't he? Century plant. Wow. It's pretty tall. All the way up to the... There he is. Huge. Really quite nice. Lots of blooms on it. So even if you don't capture it, you can remind yourself of the thing that you liked most while you were there. And go back later on and go, oh yeah, that century plant. I like painting that century plant. Maybe I should try and do a painting of the century plant now. And go do one later. Get some real bright yellow up front. Look at these guys. Wow, what a mess that made. I did want to put some of this color. We've got that violet. The salvia. Wow, how pretty. I'm going to stick them up in here. Look at salvia. It's just been an amazing spring. All that rain, it's good for the flowers, right? That's pretty much an idea of a plein air painting for y'all. Elisabet Ney, and flowers. Thanks for having me.
Yay.